Shoppers had to visit dealerships to find out what vehicles were available. But now, the internet is where most shoppers begin their search. Websites such as Edmunds.com, CarMax, and AutoTrader.com allow shoppers to search by car type, price range, and location. Many even have advanced search features, allowing you to filter your search according to specific needs. In addition to shopping around, you should research the value or invoice price of all cars you are interested in so you do not end up overpaying. For a used car, the value is more important because it takes into account the current condition of the car. Kelley Blue Book is the most well-known vehicle valuation company, and you can search car values on its website, kbb.com. Edmunds.com also offers a valuation service, which gives you a true market value for a car based on what other people have recently paid. Invoice price is more relevant to new cars. Sometimes referred to as dealer cost, it is approximately the price the dealer paid the manufacturer for the new vehicle. You can find invoice prices online at Edmunds.com and other websites. Starting your search online can save you valuable time, and knowing exactly what is out there can help you when it comes to negotiating. It may also be smart to check classified ads in newspapers, Craigslist, and Auto Trader, because you could find a great deal on a car being sold by a private party. If you plan on leasing or buying a new car, you must go through a car dealership. But if you are considering buying a used vehicle, you may think about purchasing from a private seller. Benefits of purchasing from a private seller include lower starting prices, an increased ability to negotiate, and less pressure because the seller is not likely to be a professional trained in high-pressure selling techniques. However, there are dangers to purchasing from a private seller as well. Private sellers do not have to follow the stringent laws dealers are bound by, meaning you are more likely to be cheated or swindled. In addition, warranties offered by a dealership are not available when buying from a private seller. Buying from a private seller can be a lot more hassle too. You will have to make arrangements to meet with the seller to see the vehicle, work with the seller's time schedule, and complete and submit paperwork on your own.
Some of the things that you got to really be careful about are, you know, the scams. You know, buying from an individual and, you know, send me some money and I'll send the vehicle and the car's in a different state. One thing that I've determined is that they didn't just make one of a vehicle. So if there is a 2005 Ford Taurus in New Mexico, there's probably a 2005 Ford Taurus in your local area that you can feel, touch, and smell, and drive. And so really do your homework. And unless it's a rare, rare classic car, there's a lot of vehicles, a lot of alike vehicles in your same area. And if they are priced within market value, they're all going to be priced around the same, within $1,000 or $2,000 of each other. And sometimes that deal that just sounds too good to be true usually is.
Although buying from a private seller can get you a good deal, it is usually not recommended for first-time buyers. If you decide buying from a private seller is best for you, you should do plenty of research so you know what the car is worth and what to look for when examining it.
Check the title. You know, if it's got a clean title, just because it's had a $500 fender bender, it's not always that big a concern. That's where your inspections at a reputable shop in the back, you know, all these pretty dealerships, they have service departments on the back because things go wrong when there's 10,000 pieces on a car, right? And it's built by man. So going back to the Carfax, we'll take it back there to a professional and we'll lift them up on a rack and we'll look them over. And we have like a 120-point inspection. You've heard the term certified. They actually even go steps further where we'll have to take pieces off the car and examine like brake rotors and hidden pieces that just a flashlight may not get to. And that's something that you might want to consider with a certified pre-owned.
Once you have found a car you are seriously considering purchasing, it is time to examine it in person and take it for a test drive. If you will be visiting a dealership, you might consider calling or getting online to set up an appointment. By making an appointment, you ensure the car and a salesperson will be available when you arrive. Before going to look at the car, you should create a checklist for when you are there so you do not forget to check something or ask a question. Your previous research should help you create this checklist. If you are not familiar with automotive mechanics, you may also want to research good questions to ask and factors to check, or you can talk to an auto mechanic you trust to get advice. When you are evaluating the car, stay focused and do not allow yourself to rush or ignore any items on your list. Walk around the car to look for possible damage or wear, and look under the car for possible fluid leaks. Be sure to examine all areas of the vehicle, including the engine, front seats, back seats, dashboard, floorboards, and cargo area. Test all electronic components, such as the sound system, power windows, and power seats. Always test drive the vehicle. You should test drive it the way you would drive it during your everyday life. Drive the car in both stop-and-go traffic and at highway speeds. Drive over bumps, take tight corners, and test the brakes in a safe location. Turn off music so you can listen to the engine. Throughout the process, try to stay level-headed and do not let yourself get emotionally attached to the car. Being emotional can cloud your judgment, and it can also make it harder for you to negotiate a good deal.
There's a great process to go through when you're looking, when you're going to test drive a vehicle. One thing I hope that you've determined if you need to go new or used. And if you go new, well, some of the things that you need to look for are some of your practical reasons, like your comfort and convenience, and what are your driving habits, and then see if they will mirror what that vehicle can produce. If you go used, you got to look at those same things, comfort and convenience and driving habits, but you also have to couple it with the dependability of the vehicle and how many miles the vehicle has, and when you're driving, what kind of noises are you hearing, and you know what kind of condition the vehicle is in, and the wear and tear.
If you are not completely satisfied after examining and test driving a vehicle, walk away. You can think it over at home, look at a few of your other options, or continue your search. Do not let a salesperson rush you from examination to negotiation.
One of the most important things to look for when buying a vehicle, whether it be new or used, from a dealership, is go online and look at their online reviews. Now, you're probably going to see more negative reviews than positive reviews because that's what people do. But those are the ones you want to hear about. Those are the ones you want to hear that there was a customer with a problem and how did they take care of it. And a lot of dealerships have online management systems where someone went online, made a negative review. How did they respond to that? Is there a comment underneath it, did they just dismiss it? Is it just, how many negative reviews are there? Are they coupled with some positive reviews? Because there are some people that that actually had a good experience that wanted to tell people about it. So go online, look at that dealership's reviews, and then look at their service department. How are they accommodating their customers? You're going to be a customer, and you may need their service. So when you walk into the service department, do a service walk and look at, are there people upset? Are there people just standing around? Are there people not being taken care of? You know, there is service. There is such a thing as service after the sale. It is really important, you know, to know how a dealership takes care of you. I mean, when you buy a car, is your salesman going to be gone next week? How long has he been there? You know, do a background check on your representative. You know, just, hey, how long have you been here? Ask some good questions. You know, how long have you been in the business? What do you know about it? If a salesperson really is just on the floor and he's taking up space and he doesn't know much about the product, he doesn't know much about financing, he doesn't know much about the dealership, you know, I would probably ask, and you can ask for a different salesperson that is a little bit more knowledgeable. Each dealership has a list of salespeople that are very, very good at their job. And there's a lot of salespeople that aren't.
After test driving a few of your favorites, your choice should be clear. If it isn't, take some time to think about it. Sleep on it, talk to friends and family, and continue researching. Making the right decision is important, but it is also important to be realistic about what you want and what you can get. There may be several choices which fit your needs, or you may need to look at your priorities and sacrifice one thing to get something else.